Some days you win, some days you lose. Today, I won. Traders, I'm done trading today, and I do want to talk a little bit about using indicators. And there's a good example here, which I think we should look at. And just a quick look at my account today. As you can see, I'm going to finish in green territory today. And that's mainly because of DKS. Now, you can see that I have two winners and two losers, but all of my winners and my losers are rather the same size, around 4,000 grand or so. But there's one bigger one, that's DKS, almost double winner compared to the other. And that's why I'm green today. So I'm going to finish up $3,000. And that's mainly because of DKS. Now, I do want to discuss this trade because I think it's very important, because many of you guys often ask me about using indicators, how to use indicators, should I use indicators, why don't I point them out on my charts, and so on. So let's take a quick look here at DKS. DKS, again, was my main trade today. Now, you can see that DKS started with a big gap up. So DKS started with a big gap up today, therefore, obviously, becomes a candidate. Why? Because when a stock is starting up that much, then it has a lot of followers. That means that pre-market time, people will see that it has some pre-market volume. It's likely to have an intraday volume. It has more than 5 million shares right now, and it's likely to move higher. Why? Because people love to join winners. So when DKS starts up, therefore, I mean, if we go long, then it's more likely for it to continue higher. It's supposed to be a gap and go. So I was interested in DKS. I did not follow it pre-market time. It's one of the rare occasions when I take a look at the stock only intraday, and that's what happened today with DKS. Now let's talk about my entry point here. 94.30. If you take a look at the DKS, you can see that it started with a gap up, came down a little bit, then moved over the highs, another pullback. Next move up was the point where, in my opinion, was the point of declaration, like, I want to go higher. Okay, so I rejected the lows once, I rejected the lows twice. That's what DKS whispers in my ear. And then I want to move higher. So that was the point where I wanted to move over the highs. It was before the highs, in fact, 94.32 or so. I posted it in the trading room. I went long, and what happens right next? It came down. Well, you know, nobody really cares about my entry point. Stock doesn't care, the market doesn't care, nobody cares about my entry point. The only thing right now left is to manage my entry point, manage this trade correctly. Now, is there a reason to think that DKS will become a losing trade? No, it's not likely. Stock is up, has big gap up. It's likely to gap and go, likely to continue higher. Now I only need to manage it correctly. I should have a stop loss somewhere. Stop loss lies at the point. Well, let me just start with that. First, you need to trust it to continue higher. Why? Because it's strong, because it's trending higher, because there's nothing wrong about the stock. It's likely to move higher. So if you're going to be taken out of this trade, please remember that it probably has more than 65% chance to continue higher today. So please be careful about your stop loss. Now, if we have that in mind, the fact that it's likely to continue higher, now we need to take a look at the intraday and decide where would be our intraday stop. And I'm glad to say that I did not move out, although it had a big pullback. So I moved in at 94.30 or so, and it came all the way down to 92, 70 something, 75 or so. So it came down, what, 1.5 point, 1.60, something like that. So it came down quite a lot. And of course, look, the target, it still goes. I mean, it's moved over $99. So just to see the potential, you can see that $94.99, I mean, it moved up 5 points or so. So the potential was there, although it pulled back down $1.50 or so. So you take a look at the behavior of the stock, and I will say something I said earlier, nothing wrong happened. If you take a look at the chart, I don't care how much money you're losing, really seriously. I don't care how many stocks you bought and you moved into this trade. If you bought too many stocks, once it pulled back down, you probably moved out. Why? Because your size was too high. if there's somebody brave enough to say that he joined me and the stock took him out, it's the time to say that. Nothing wrong about that. You're still learning, right? I mean, many of you are learning. So if you took this trade with me and you couldn't hang on because it pulled back down, please say yes or something so we will know. But anyway, the stock pulled down quite a bit. And, you know, and the question is, where should I have my stop? The where should I have my stop lies in the behavior of the stock. I need you to imagine all times. I need you to imagine the uptrend. Now, it's not a problem to imagine it right now because it happened. Look at the way the stock behaved. Look at the way it moves. For example, if you look at this high before I bought it, you can see that stock moved up to 94.30. And then it pulled back down. That's the bottoming tail right here. It pulled back down to 92.40. So from 94.30 to 92.40, we've got what, $61 to more than this pull, like, you know, almost 2 points here. So that's a big pullback. That means the stock could pull back quite a lot. And then once it moves another move up, that's not a problem for the stock. I mean, technically speaking, if you look back at the behavior of the previous behavior of the stock, you can see that it has this volatility. It can do it. And plus, I want you to imagine the move. Now, you don't have to use your imagination again because you can see that it's uptrending. So just imagine this pullback and then a new high, and there's nothing wrong about it. But you need to imagine the new high before you move out of the stock. That's the whole idea here. You see it moving down. Now at that point where you're down, you're losing money. And again, I don't care how many stocks you bought, because if you bought 1,000 stocks and you couldn't hang on, you were probably out. But think again, if you had only 100 shares, would you move out with 100 shares? Probably not. So does it have is the problem is your size? So think again about your size, right? I mean, that's the problem. Your size is the problem, probably. So anyway, it pulled back down. It did nothing wrong. Seriously, it did nothing wrong. It was uptrending. It already had this kind of pullback earlier. You can see that it's volatile enough. You can see that it's at that point did nothing wrong. Again, if it would have continued down, possibly move under this recent low, well, then I should have my stop and move out with a loss, of course. Again, does not matter how many stocks I have. So now at that point, nothing wrong. And then it stopped, it reversed. I'm glad that Scott pointed out that he wants to buy some more over 94. And I joined in, I added to this beautiful uptrending stock before it moved to a new high, and then it continued moving higher. And the reason it became such a big winner is because I added. Not only did I add at 94 when Scott pointed it out, I also added once more over the highs, and it just kept going. So that was my main trade. I trusted it. It was strong, it was looking good, and it continued to trade. Now let's talk a little bit about indicators. You don't often see me use indicators on my charts. It's not because you don't need them. It's not because I don't need them. I need them. I need them just like you do. And I teach people how to use them. And some of them are very important. The reason you don't see them on my chart, it's because they are already embedded in my mind. I'm trading for 21 years almost. So for 21 years, if I'm looking at the chart, I don't really need my indicators on the chart. I know where they are. I'm looking at the chart and I'm seeing the first low right here, the new high, the pullback, a new high, and so on. And I'm thinking, well, you know, it does not look like it's likely to do something wrong. If you take a look at Fibonacci, if you take a look at every indicators that you use, which are, in my case, embedded in my mind, you will see that there's really no reason to move out. So indicators are a very important tool. You should be using indicators. You should be using them to point out where, if it's not clear to you that at some point a stock that is trending higher pulled back down too much from the highs, then the indicators could help you. In my case, I don't need it. Do you need it? Well, depends on how long you've been trading. So just in my case, I was looking at DKS. There was really no reason for me to move out of this trade. It looks perfect. It looked perfectly well. That's why when it proved to me that it's uptrending again, I added over $94 and I kept adding. And that's why DKS became my main trade. And that's why I'm green today, because I have two winners, two losers. But when you do it the right way, when you trade the right way, then you know that's how it goes. Your winners should be bigger than your losers. It's not always true, it's not always the case, but I would say it happens more often than it doesn't. So I'm going to finish green today because I trusted DKS and because I trusted the trend, because I imagined the trend, and that's what you should do as well.
Meir, a question for you that, you know, just listening to you roll through that, you know, I'm at the stage now for trading such a long time that I don't rely on many indicators, and it goes hand in hand, I think, with your, you know, with your trading style. But if you're just starting off, if you look back over your 20 years in your trading career, if you're just now starting off like many of our traders are today, what if you were to use two indicators, or if you were to look at Fibonacci perhaps, what would be the one or two that you would say, I don't need to look at a ton of them because there's so many out there, as you and I know, there's even on the platform, I mean, you could choose from 20, 25 indicators to put on your charts. What would you tell the young Meir, the person that's just now starting, to use to kind of get that jump, that thing that would help them from now when they're first starting into the future?
I'm a big fan, you know, Scott, for VWAP, and I think VWAP is one of the most important indicators out there. So definitely think you guys should be using VWAP. And other than VWAP, you should be using Fibonacci. And it's not because this guy Fibonacci who lived 800 years ago knew something about what's going on with the market today. It's just because people are using it. So the fact that Fibonacci works because it's a fact. It's a fact because people are using it. So it's a self-fulfilled prophecy, maybe, but it is a fact. People are using Fibonacci. And in fact, if you're looking at these pullbacks over here, you can see that they kind of found their support at the Fibonacci. If you take a look at the main move from here to there, I could point it out to you with Fibonacci. So just take a look at the lows here and take a look at the highs here. And you can see that the main Fibonacci, which is 61.8%, is like 10 cents below the reversal point over here. So it's a little bit hard to see now, but if you use your Fibonacci on your chart and you possibly enlarge it a little bit, you can see that the pullback happened just at the Fibonacci point, just a few cents off the Fibonacci point. So you can see that the whole idea of Fibonacci really is to say, what does look perfect in the human eye? I mean, the whole idea of Fibonacci is, does that look perfect in the human eye? So that's the golden pullback, the golden retracement in this case. So the Fibonacci retracement is important because people are using it. When a stock is pulling back down 61.8%, it does not have to be exactly the same, but close to that point, then there will be buyers. People will start buying it. Why? Because it looks in their eyes, possibly looks in their eyes, perfect. And that's why Fibonacci does work. And I would say moving averages is important. Well, you need to find out. It also depends on your trading style, you know. So it depends on what you do. It depends on if you're a swing trader or you're day trading. What are your systems? If you're an intraday trader that holds for a few minutes to a few hours like I do, then you should be using VWAP for sure. And if you're a little bit longer on the intraday time frame, then Fibonacci is extremely important. That's a big discussion. Then everyone has his own ideas and his own systems, his own trading system. And I guess it changes from one trader to another. So there's no right or wrong answer here. It's just some are considered to be the main indicator. Some are used more than other. That's it.
Traders, just to comment on that, it really, the way that I look at it right now, I don't really care what it's called, Fibonacci, Ichinacci, whatever it is. I just want to be, I want to be using the same, support and resistance, these same things that everybody else is using. I want to be like everybody else because, you know, like I do, that if more people are using it across the world, then they're buying and selling off of the same levels that you and I are, which makes our trading, you know, our percentages a lot higher to win and to be able to achieve what we do on a daily basis because we're trading with a lot of the same tools that many traders are, especially like you put the VWAP. And I think it's important for everybody to understand that, you know, the better chances that you have and the more that you're, the more people that are buying and selling off of the same levels, the better chance you're going to have to succeed, right, Meir?
True. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, it's a long process to understand everything, and the best way to do is to pick your indicator, see how it works for you, see how it works for your trading system, and possibly continue with this indicator, and then possibly leave it or change it, and try out some other. So it depends on your trading style, depends on what you do. There's no right and wrong answer here. And you know, I have been using indicators quite a lot until, I don't know, 7-8 years ago, and then I stopped because I feel like a clean chart is working better for me. And again, if I look on the chart and you ask me where the Fibonacci is, I'll tell you where it is. I may have a few cents, I may get it a few cents wrong here and there, but the whole idea of a Fibonacci is what looks perfect in the human eye. And just remember, you're looking for approximately 60% pullback. I mean, it's not hard to watch the chart and guess where 60% pullback. So it does not have to be 61.8. I mean, just imagine the 60% pullback and you got it. You don't need a chart. You don't need to put it on charts to know where the Fibonacci is. But again, you work as I am for more years, and then you need less indicators on your charts, and you kind of like it to be clean, and that's what I do. Anyway, traders, I hope it was helpful, and thank you for participating. Thank you for being with us. It was a nice day. Not easy. Two winners, two losers. But again, if you do it correctly, should be on the green side. Well, that's it. Thank you. And if you are on YouTube, please give us a thumb up. It helps our channel, helps more people like you to learn a little bit more about day trading. So that's it. Have a nice day, and I'll see you all tomorrow. Bye, traders.
Meir, take care of yourself. Have a great evening tonight, and we will see you first thing in the morning.
Thanks.
Tomorrow for a Thursday session.